Welcome to Let's Play Forza Motorsport 4, Part 2. And here we go. It's time to actually get into this bitch. So let me just go to my profile real quick. It's the options, and I'm just going to show off what my HUD options are going to be. I guess I'll keep camera motion effects on for now, because I don't know exactly what it does. Yes, yes, wrong way warning. Sure, I'll keep that on, even though I don't really need it. Yes, analog speedometer. I'll have to show off the digital speedometer at some point. Someone's going to have to remind me of that. Distance ahead on. You need be rewind message off, because fuck rewind. Race feeds on. That's something new. And drift HUD off, because fuck drifting. Race feeds I'll get into once we get into the races. So there we go. I've got audio settings, which is very basic, and multi-screen. I don't know if I'm going to have to do the multi-screen trick like I did in Forza 3, but. And we got the usual, my stats, general stats. We have badges now, which are things. Badges and titles, which is mostly for online. You can unlock badges as you play the game and stuff through achieving things. So, yeah, as well as titles. It's more for online stuff. I don't give a fuck. Online, like, personalization. Anyways. Let's just move on to the racing, shall we? So, as usual, we can look at our garage. We only have this, you know, this Igo right now. 90 horsepower, 91 pound-feet of torque. Aw, yeah. Can buy cars. Take a photo. Can change our home space. Just basically changing the background. So we have the Top Gear test track, because hey, Top Gear, that's a thing. You know, they had the Jeremy Clarkson voice, so yeah. I'm gonna keep the Mountain Pass background on, because it looks really nice, so yeah. Reminds me of Forza 3 with Camino Viejo for the background images. Anyways, upgrade our car, change setup. Still quick upgrade. Of course, you know, you have all kinds of shit you can upgrade. Do engine swaps, powertrain swaps. Or you can just quick upgrade to a specific class. Apparently this thing can go all the way up to A class. Interesting. I think the classes are the same as Forza 3. I don't know. Of course, you can paint the car, which I'm not going to get into, because I'm not, you know, a car artist. Ooh. But anyways, let's go race. And I accidentally already clicked this menu. There was supposed to be a voice saying, oh, go click World Tour or whatever. So there's World Tour, which replaces Season Play from Forza 3. The Event List, which is just like Forza 3. And the Rivals, which is an online thing, I believe. Yeah, it's an online feature. So let's go to the World Tour.
World Tour takes you on an expedition of the world's most elite racing circuits in some of the fastest cars available. You begin your career in the amateur division. Here you will compete against subcompact cars in a short 5-race season. Now we move to the Ladera Test Track, a facility dedicated to the testing of cutting-edge automotive technology. At each racing circuit, you can choose from several events. Displayed events are suitable for either your current car or cars in your garage.
So yeah, here we go. This is the World Tour menu. A little bit different, as you see. We have three choices here of series, but this works a little differently from Season Play. You could hear the thing echoing through my TV. I don't give a fuck. Anyways, see, the race, no matter what we choose, the race is going to take place at Ladera Short for 3 laps, but we can pick one of 3 race types, depending on what the game gives us, and, this is going to be interesting, because a lot of these races we're going to do in the World Tour are not going to be part of the event list. There might be like a select few that actually are in the event list, but yeah, so we can actually do races that aren't actually part of the event list and stuff, and blah 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 blah. So we have the city car body style, We have a three-cylinder shootout, and we have Class F Euro Tour we can choose from, and each of these has a different type of bonus you can get as well. As you see, the City Car Open has a 50% credits bonus. Three-cylinder shootout has a 3,000 credit bonus, so basically 100% in this situation. And the Euro Tour has a 25% driver level bonus. I'm going to go with the three-cylinder shootout.
From here, you can manage your settings prior to racing, or simply select Start Race to get right on the track.
So, here we go. Here's our race preview screen. You can check out our opponents. Got a couple Micros, Peugeot 107s, Citroëns, and Kim in another Aygo, but lower PI. Hooray. So we have our usual suspects as far as AI drivers. We've got Sasaki, Takahashi, Evans, Weber. All of them, their usual skill things. You can review the restrictions. You can, of course, change your car, but I don't have anything else eligible. You can check out the progress of the season, which also spoils the tracks we're going to go to in this. And we can set the difficulty. Now, you know me, I'm a crazy person, so we have easy, medium, hard, advanced, and expert. I'm going with expert because I'm cool, and just to make sure that everything is off, just going to make sure everything's perfect. So, no ABS, simulation steering, stability control off, traction control off, shifting manual with clutch, suggested line off, simulation fuel tire wear and damage, no, can actually turn rewinds off. So you can just have them completely turned off, hooray. And then a World Tour bonus. So a total of 165% bonus from selecting this difficulty. So hooray. Let me just, okay, just make sure. So here we go. Let us start our first actual race of the game. Since Prologue Race, meh. It's the amateur division, yeah! Race number 1 of 5. So here's our pre-race screen, shows the series we're doing, the car we're driving, blah blah blah, blah 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 blah, blah 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 blah, anyways. And then of course the track we're going to as it loads. And also the track location, which is interesting. So here's our pre-race menu, much like Forza 3's, just with a different coat of paint. Can tune setup, load setup, change the difficulty, change options, change HUD options, all that jazz. So let's get to racing. Where am I starting on the grid? I am starting 6th on the grid. Also, if you notice, I have my name is in this game is RhinoGT4 instead of R. Burton. I'm using like my main Xbox Live account for this LP. Because, oh my god, this is loud. Anyways, sorry, I was turning it down on my TV. Anyways, yeah, there's a reason why I'm using my main account. It has to do with DLC. That's all as far as I'm going with that. Anybody who knows Forza 4 knows what I'm talking about, so, you know, it's not really a secret. But here we go in our first race, and, also, since I am using my, main Xbox Live account, that means I already have pretty much all the I think I have all the single player achievements for this game already unlocked, so no achievement unlocks for this LP. Oh no, what a tragedy. And I've already pulled the fuck away, hooray. So, yeah. But if you notice on the top left of the HUD, which is pretty much the same, except, you know, different coat of paint. Everything's in the same place, yada yada yada. Underneath the leaderboard, there's a thing that shows, like I said, turn 3 out of 4. That's the, whatever the thing was called in the HUD. It basically judges you on how well you execute an overtake or a turn. It's purely cosmetic. It doesn't actually give you any bonuses or anything. It might give you like an achievement. I think there's an achievement for like your first perfect turn and stuff, but yeah. Other than that, it does not matter at all. But I'm gonna keep it up there just for shits and giggles. Here we go, final lap of our first race. I have a 1,300 foot lead already on Sasaki. Very good. Now you can see on the map, they're not even close to the line. 16 second lead. Jesus Christ, 16 seconds. If there's any upgrade, I wonder if there's any upgrades on this thing. If so, I'm taking these upgrades off. If it's gonna be this piss easy. Actually, it might just be for this first race, because, you know, I don't know. Unfortunately, no AI difficulty options in the World Tour mode, so I just kind of have to take what I'm given. But oh well. So there we go, first race done. And just like Forza 3, we have all the bells and whistles, we can restart the race, view replay, save the replay, look at the leaderboards, but that's an Xbox Live feature. And of course, look at the race results, so I'm gonna have to wait 500 years for everyone to finish. Oh fucking joy. Oh god. Hey, look, Sasaki made it across the line. 25 seconds behind me. Oh god. Alright, well, there we go. Our first event is complete. And here's, we got unlocked new badges and titles. Hooray, I don't care. So, 3,000 for winning. A difficulty bonus of 4,950 because 165% or whatever. Ooh, okay. We actually do get a credit bonus for race feats. I didn't remember that. Hooray. And then no repair fee because I didn't damage the car at all. And then we get the credits bonus from choosing this event for a big payout. So we have our usual XP, and we also have something that's different in this game, is the affinity level. Now, instead of like in Forza 2 where each individual car had their own levels, this game has an affinity level which is tied to the manufacturer. So the more you drive a car of a manufacturer, the higher that manufacturer's affinity level will go, to which you can get rewards such as 1,000 credits from Toyota and also a 25% discount on Toyota parts. Basically, it's very easy to level up the affinity of a manufacturer and then just have every upgrade be free on the car. It doesn't take many levels at all to do that. It's kind of broken that way, but hey, it makes for more experimentation.
Complete races to circle the globe and test your skill on a variety of tracks from around the world. Now it's off to Road Atlanta, one of America's classic circuits. From additional credits to affinity boosts, each race provides different bonuses for both your car and driver.
Yeah, I think he was explaining the bonuses there. Anyways, to Road Atlanta short for our next race. I really like this map thing. It's cool. Anyways, we have the Class F North American Tour with a 25% driver level bonus, City Car Open with 50% credits bonus, and we also have the Class E North American Tour with a random driver level bonus. But I'm going to go with the... let's go with the City Car Open for the...
With each completed race, you increase your affinity level for your car's manufacturer. As your affinity level increases, you'll receive parts discounts and cash prizes.
Thank you for explaining what I just explained. Anyways. Hey, it's our good friend M. Rossi. Here he is. Oh boy. Yep, M. Rossi is here, and he's driving a Vauxhall Agila. Alright. So, let's check the season status. Ooh, look at that shit. I won't check season status all the time, but yeah. Let's race at Road Atlanta Short. So, in this race, I'm going to cycle through all the different camera options, and I'm also going to show off the digital tack just this once. I got to show it off once, even though I'm never going to use it again. Hooray. So, loading screen. So, here I go. Road Atlanta Club Circuit. Called the Club Circuit, excuse me. So, here we go. So, let me just, where the fuck is it? Speedometer. Digital insanity. Starting six on the grid again. I'm not sure what the whole gridding placement is in this game. I think it just grids you in like sixth place all the time. I don't fucking know for sure, but let's race at Road Atlanta, shall we? Here we go. There's the digital spin. Oh my god, I do not like the digital tax. I don't know why. I just greatly prefer the analog tacks. They're much easier for me to judge, like, shifting points and stuff. So, yeah. Anyways, hey, look, I'm getting things for passing people. Apparently I'm not doing good at overtaking. Ooh. So, let's go through the cameras. We have this chase, we have further away chase camera, then we have the interior view, which is actually a lot better than Forza 3's by default. So I don't think I'm gonna have to do the multi-screen trick for this game, if that is even possible in this game. I know it isn't 3 because, you know, I did it, but I don't know about this game. So that's good. And then we have the hood cam with a rear view, virtual mirror, and the bumper cam. So I think that's all the same 5 camera angles from Forza 3. Notice how I'm mentioning a lot of it's the same as Forza 3. I mean, this game is basically as Forza 3, just with more stuff. And a different career mode. Kind of. You know, with the World Tour is set up differently than the season play. You know, since this is actually, the World Tour is pretty disconnected from the event list. Except when you do that rare event, that is actually that rare track race type combination that's actually part of the event list. Oh, and I might as well just say this now. If I do happen to do one of the combinations that's part of the event list, once I get to the event list part of the game, I'm going to redo that race anyways, despite already having a gold trophy. So, yeah. Just be prepared for that. So anyways, going around town, 9 second lead on Rossi. Yeah, man, this first, well, it is the amateur division, so, you know, beginning of the game, it shouldn't be surprising that this is piss easy. I mean, this is, you know, fucking night and day compared to how Forza 3 started, with me having to basically be a huge dirty driver in order to win the early races because of how short and difficult they were. God, that shit was ridiculous. Here, not so much. I can just kind of take it easy. And stuff, and take an easy win in my Igo. Of course, M. Rossi driving the red, the ever-present red. So, hey, you can actually see, game actually shows driver colors again. That was one thing that was absent from Forza 3, so returning from Forza 2 is the actual, like, noting of driver colors, which is cute. Cute, yeah, anyways. So there we go. Beat Rossi by almost 15 seconds, very good. And we finished our second race. Here's our payout, 10,000 credits, nice. And we've reached driver level 1, hooray. So, in reward for reaching level 1, I don't fucking know what I was trying to say, I get a free car, but instead of being a specific car, I actually have a choice between a certain number of cars, which is really cool.
Well done. You've reached a new driver level. This earns you a choice of gift cars. Keep racing to continue your progress and earn additional vehicles.
Yeah, that. Anyways, so, hooray. So we have the Sport Super Minis for my level 1 reward. I can either get a Toyota Yaris, a meme car, Ford Fiesta Z-Tech, Suzuki SX4, Fiat Punto, Mazda 2, Honda Fit, or Cyan XD. I'm gonna go with Silicone Sally here. I forget which your Mr. Regular's fit is, but hey, this is close enough, I guess. I guess I'll get it in black to match Silicone Sally. Because why the fuck not? So, onwards to our next event.
Your next race is at the infamously tight and technical Tsukuba Circuit in Shimotsuma, Japan.
Oh shit, it's Tsukuba time, motherfuckers. It's the short circuit, yay! So we have the Class F Asian Tour JDM Micro Battle and the economy car open for this one. Available for this one. I'm just gonna stick with Class F just because I said so. So, yeah, we're gonna do the Asian Tour. Stick with the Aigo. I'm gonna try to, like, use the same car in the same class, basically, throughout. I have a very specific way I wanted to go about the World Tour here, so let's hope I can actually do that. We've got Sasaki heading the field in this one, and a Kia Ceed. Alright. Got a really interesting list of cars here that I've don't even remember existing, like a Kia Ceed, a Suzuki Liana, Hyundai iX20, you know, shit like that. So, off we go to Tsukuba Short for our third race of five in the amateur division. Yes, I'm doing the amateur divisional in the stupid. I don't fucking know what I'm saying. I'm really bad at this commentary stuff. Like, once I get past the part where I'm, like, explaining everything, it's just gonna be like, hey, badikabuku, wow, you person in the chat's being really fucking stupid. What a shock. Oh my god. And, you know, business as usual, basically. Oh god. Alright, here's the starting lineup. I'm leading the Aigo charge from the back. Also, let's just change my speedometer back to analog. Fuck. So, here we go. Round number three at Tsukuba. Tsukuba. And just like how I was doing in Forza 3, I'm going to, each race I'm going to alternate between the chase cam and the interior cam. So, hooray, consistency. I go around the outside of everyone in my Aigo. Oh, I go a little wide. Okay, alright, Takahashi, come at me, bro. He's not coming at me very well. Sucks to be you. Oh yeah, one more thing I just remembered I haven't showed off yet. The telemetry screen. That hasn't gone away. That's still here, so we have our telemetry screen, of course. The usual stuff. Of course there's gonna be puns. I'm a punny guy, haha. Always liked the telemetry. I never, like, used the telemetry screen, but I always liked it actually being in the game. Just to show, like, how much information the game is calculating and having to display at all times. It's fucking crazy. Especially for something like, you know, those tires. Like, it's showing, like, camber, tire speed, temperatures, pressure, tire wear in, like, real time. Of course, tire temperatures. And the damage screen. Thought there was a way to show the damage, like, mini thing on, like, shows up on the ride, but I guess not until, what's this button? I don't know why I tried the clutch button. That definitely isn't it. Y is for rewinds, I know that, which I turned off, so Y is actually completely useless. I don't know. Oh, okay, so I have to click the right thumbstick for it to show up, I see. Hey, we can see our tire temps from here. I'm just gonna keep that on, because why not? Look at my tire temps. I might try to, like, keep that up at all times. I'm totally gonna forget a lot, but hey, whatever. I don't give a frick. I'm gonna try. So, there we go. Our third race complete. And AI was much closer this time. Good. I didn't want to win by like 15 million seconds in a 3-second race. Yeah, that makes sense, right? Yeah, okay. So there we go. Scuba down, so let's figure out. Oh, I didn't get any kind of bonus. Huh, interesting. And reached affinity level 2. Oh, nope, we got a driver level bonus. Never mind. Never mind, I'm stupid. Alright. So hey, we've reached Toyota Affinity Level 2, another 2,000 credits from Toyota, and also, just for reaching Affinity Level 2, half off of all Toyota upgrades. Like I said, it's easy to get just free upgrades for everything.
Today you travel to Dunsfold, England, the home of the BBC's hit series Top Gear and their famous test track.
Welcome to the Top Gear Challenge. Now, the idea here is to knock down as many pins as possible in just one lap. Each event has a target score for you to beat, or try to beat.
So yeah, here's something incredibly new. Both in venue and also in event type. We have bowling here, and we also have the Top Gear track. You know, the famous Top Gear track. So we could have to choose from Class F, Class F2, or Class E Top Gear Challenge. I'm going to go with the first Class F for the 100% credits bonus. So, here we go. Opponent list. Nobody, because I'm on my own, because I'm fucking going to be bowling here. We're doing car bowling. This is one of my favorite silly game modes that they added with this game. Because it's just drive around, knock over a million pins. It's pretty great. So yeah, here we go. Our target score, 142,000 points. Let's do it. Hey cousin, let's go bowling. So yeah, here's what we do. We go around the Top Gear track. Cones are, well, not cones, bowling pins are laid along the road, and we just have to knock as many over as we can. White pins are worth however many points they're worth. Then there's gold pins, which are worth even more points. And I'm really bad at doing this, like, effectively. Like, you want to kind of slide into the pins to knock over as many as you can. But this car is such a short wheelbase, it's kind of hard to slide it efficiently. Oh my god. At least I'm going to blame it on the wheelbase. Also, you have to be going a certain amount of speed in order to score. So, yeah. Oh well. We around kind of Hammerhead, but not really. Going the other way. Here's some golden pins. Those things are, yeah. You want to hit those, because those are worth a lot of points. Oh my god! It might be a combination like short wheelbase and also simulation steering, which is just fucking very hard to recover from, very hard to counter steer, basically. If it's anything like Forza 6, I honestly haven't played this game in forever, I don't even remember. And I've already won the event, so it doesn't matter. Just knock over some more cones, pins. Pins, get more points, and win. Hooray. Beat the target by 30,000 points, oh yeah. Sweet. Reach level 2. Hooray, it means we get another free car. This game likes throwing a bunch of free shit at you. Free money, free cars, free upgrades, free everything. So here we have ready-to-tune cars, as the game describes. So we have Volkswagen Golf, a Toyota MR2, an MX-5 Miata, a Nissan 240SX, and a Honda Civic VTI. I'm going to get the MX-5 because I like the MX-5. I am an MX-5 fan. So, it's a cool car. And let's get it in blue. It's because why not? So, hey, bowling's done. Yay! Isn't that cool?
Our next destination is Baden-Württemberg, Germany, home of the Hockenheimring. A championship event consists of two individual heats. The first takes place in the morning, and the final before the sun sets in the afternoon.
So yeah, here's something special. That, it's world championship time as we reach the end of the amateur division. Now, I'm going to get more into this in the next segment, because, I'm going to be doing the world championship races separately from the rest of this World Tour shit. So, with that, that'll end this segment of Forza 4, so stay tuned for our first world championship race in the end of the amateur division.